As Fan Zhendong stretches it out, he's been wearing a back brace throughout this event. There will be no coaches on the benches. It's a best of seven. The battle begins.
Ma Long has been on for 3 hours, 23 minutes. When you compare that to some of the other timings we've seen.
It's like it's his first match.
Love two.
Now, we talked about their last encounters. Fan Zhendong, 10 hours on court compared to 3 hours, 23 minutes.
Three times as long as his opponent.
Jeez.
That's, and he's. He got into very deep, didn't he, into different competitions.
1-2.
Won the men's doubles with Monkey Chi.
Right, different categories here at this event. It's interesting, you mentioned five of the last eight have been won by Fan Zhendong. The last time they played, it was internal in China, but it was Ma Long quite comfortably.
2-0.
That would have been obviously not part of that head-to-head that we're talking about.
Correct.
And that would have been very recently? Or
quite recently. It feels like it was about a month ago, give or take. I mean, us table tennis fans, we jump all over that as soon as it comes out. Everybody finds it online and watches.
3-2.
Yeah, that's quite telling. And those internal matches are taken extremely seriously, right?
It's a good question. It's a good question. I think the answer should be yes, but it's going to be a case-by-case basis. And same with performance. So in terms of quite telling, still a lot right here to discover live.
He was making those kind of shots every time he spoke play that Ma Long.
Right. We've been talking about this quite a lot, that Ma Long at the back of the table, where other people are not comfortable, he still is. You can move it a few centimeters inside the baseline, and he's still able to aggressively play. But Fan Zhendong makes these subtle adjustments to get two-thirds of the first 6 points.
Five.
Ma Long probably, Adam, I think it's fair to say, here at the Infinity Arena, has been close to flawless the way we've watched. He's dropped one game so far to Hugo Calderano. Fan Zhendong has shown a bit of vulnerability. But it's fine at the moment. He's doing really well here.
Yeah, this is the type of start that would be quite thrilled with. We've seen some one-sided matches between these two, and in recent history, Fan Zhendong has had the better of those results in their head-to-head. But when it's really counted, I don't know. I mean, last year's final, for example.
Yeah, you're right. Last year's final was indeed. Well, it's 4-3. It's 4-3.
And a reminder, Fan Zhendong fighting to defend.
Leading by five already.
He
breaks that run of points, Ma Long.
We talked earlier about how when players already know so much about their opponent, game plans are a little bit different. The tricks that you have up your sleeve, the subtle changes, a little bit too familiar for the opponent. It forces you to create a new game.
A couple of points in a row here for Ma Long, looking to claw back that pretty big deficit that he was facing.
This is the beauty of time. This coming of age story, Fan Zhendong, when he was breaking onto the scene, it was a dream to be able to play with Ma Long. Now, his greatest rival. Wow, not too often you see that. Don't know if it caught the edge of the racket, but it was like the world's fastest serve mid-rally. Take a look one more time here. Quick shot comes down into his own side of the table. The only explanation for that typically would be bottom of the racket, miss hit. But this is a sign of respect. I mean, we've seen it in swimming. We've seen it around the world. Kids have inspiration. And then when they finally reach that level. Oh, interesting. 2-point game.
8-5.
So things a bit tighter here than we realized, I guess. Saw 4-8 on screen for a moment, thought, huh, pulling ahead.
Yeah. Bohm winning that longer rally. Getting up to 4 points.
Now, one main difference between these two, Bang Zhendong, the more explosive of the two players. He's got more power on both wings, backhand to backhand. He's the stronger of the two. Ma Long's backhand, while it's still one of the best in the world, it's excellent partially because it's divisive, it's consistent. Meaning he can find ways to make it tricky and uncomfortable. He's got a large sweet spot. He might not have the power of Bang Zhendong, but right now he doesn't have the positioning either. 5 game points for the world number one in this clash.
That's looking very good here.
Let 5-10.
So Fang Zhendong wraps up a pretty fairly comfortable loss for Fang Zhendong in the first game. Because Ma Long dropped one game coming into this. That was an 8-11 against Hugo Calderano. There's a completely different player we're talking about here.
Right, and that's also the interesting thing here. When you look at the draw matters so much.
Yeah.
Beautiful counter punch here. Fang Zhendong fast and flat down the middle as the rally extends there. See the Fang Zhendong fan club. While Ma Long plays one backhand from the backhand side, it's not as strong as Fang Zhendong's. That's part of the reason he stepped around for the first forehand, but he can't afford to spend too much time there. You might even say Fang Zhendong has him figured out to some extent. But a good read there on the step around. And clearly he's not completely figured out. After all, Ma Long just beat him steadily internally in China. So on any given day, the touch is working, tactics are changing a bit. Could go either way with these two.
Oh, he's playing out of his skin right now, Fang Zhendong.
After a good attempt here, watch Ma Long turn for the forehand. Nice counter, wide and on the run, short side of the table. It hits the hand of Ma Long on the way back. Still legal, just tough to control. So, Shahzad, you had a question for me that I thought the world might want to know.
Yeah, I was curious, since you were talking about that internal match that these two had, and it was pretty recent, what was the, because you said Marlon won it, what was the margin of victory?
3-0, 8-5, and 7. Those were the scores for Fang Zhendong.
Which makes it a little bit surprising at the moment with what we're seeing, but great, that's very comprehensive.
Yeah, 3 weeks ago that happened. It was quite smooth, quite impressive. I mean, it just looked like the speed of Ma Long in that match was untouchable. Did that light a fire under Fang Zhendong? Did that just inspire him to come up with some new plans?
A lovely return there for Ma Long.
Yeah, really wise placement. Whenever you've got someone playing a forehand from deep in the backhand corner, that means they're going to have a long way to go, but that was shallow with side spin, a bending ball to really force Fang Zhendong to not only move to his forehand side, but right back in. Not telling secrets to the racket, just breathing on it to fog it up and then clean off the dust on that top sheet of rubber to make sure he can spin and grip the ball.
Now, Ma Long, he looks like he's in the zone finally.
Scoreboard. Backhand down the line, quick too. Doesn't always have to be the most powerful shot, but if it's surprising, it's going to be tough for the opponent to react to. Not as much time there for the world number one.
I remember telling you that Marlon felt his quarterfinal match against Dang Zhou of Germany was his best in a year.
It's quite a compliment to Dong Chiu. Or just a statement of fact about how Ma Long felt he played in that match. But it would explain the scores, too, right? How many players can say that they played Ma Long when he felt like he played the best match of the last 12 months of his life?
Right.
This is after, I mean, he recently just won 3-0 over the world number one.
And that wasn't his best match?
Right. Good for Dong Chiu.
Yeah, that's one he'd be looking to put away. Fun Zedong makes no mistake there.
Look at that reverse pendulum serve. Follows it up quickly after getting a slightly popped up receive. 3 points between them. Wow, Ma Long really stepped it up here. Yeah. For example, another
just to,
one.
Exemplify what you said.
Yeah, could we have a few more demonstrations of this whole stepping it up thing that we hear about? Turns the corner, knows that he's going to have some room. This is one of the many things that makes Ma Long so dangerous, how quickly he identifies an opportunity. And sometimes it doesn't seem like an opportunity in quotes, as we see the fan club here. Pretty good mix. Again, a lot of Fan Zhendong signs there and a lot of Ma Long, the GOAT.
The right way up?
Every single one of them. I think they heard the broadcast yesterday. I actually got some messages on social media showing the people with their signs upside down in the front row. Too much fun.
Oh, that's good fun.
Nice combination of backhands there, a pair. One in front of the backhand, a little bit on the elbow, one wide. Big serve here.
We've seen a number of those top edges. That traveled a long way as well from Ma Long's racket.
For me, this is stressful for Ma Long. I know that's a weird sentence, but I can see it on his face. Normally, he has such an advantage on the serve that it's just a very easy way for him to get a third ball attack, but Fan Zhendong has shut that down quite well and changed the percentages. It's going to force Ma Long to really think in a new way.
How good was that? Fan Zhendong. Delicate.
Just punishing Ma Long for turning. Float serve there. Underspin, you could see. Push back long, and he goes the other way as soon as Ma Long turns. Ma Long's fast, but he's going to have to rely on his backhand. Or just wait a second longer before he starts to move, because Fan Zhendong, he knows these tricks, and he's too clever. 1 point game now.
Tolley!
This is smart. It's exactly what we just talked about. Ma Long waiting on the backhand here. Again, he's not going to overpower Fan Zhendong in a backhand-to-backhand rally, but he times it right, plays it out in front, and waits patiently. Much like in 2017, 6 years ago, he said, I will let you take the first attack, you powerful player, you. But get ready to recover and get back in position. It's like using someone's own power against them, just except without the word like. Shot block had worked well for him for some time, but a little bit rushed here as Fan Zhendong races to that backhand corner.
Didn't like that, did he? Look at his reaction here.
He's incredibly consistent with that shot, but at this level, you just have to wonder how many times it's going to work out in his favor. Truls Morgaard was incredibly effective with this chop block against Fan Zhendong, but it hasn't worked out for Ma Long quite the same this event.
And he's got two game points of his own here, Ma Long.
A lot of thought about the what ifs, what this means for the future. If you're just tuning in and you see this as a China-China match, well, we have a lot of information to give you about these two and why this rivalry is so fascinating between two very different players from different generations. The gatekeeper on the receive with two game points.
So he saves one game point here, Fan Zhendong.
Ma Long looks young. You might look at him and think, okay, mid-20s. 34, he'll be 35 on October 20th. Which for Team China, only one male player I can think of has played to 35 years old for the Chinese team, and Ma Long might surpass that. Second game point for Ma Long.
Let 9-10.
Went for it there, Ma Long. But it's all square now.
That's where he's used to being able to take advantage of an opponent. Everyone practices their half-long serves, and he figures, you know what? I can close that window. I can force people to play out of their comfort zone by stealing the receive on the half-long serve. But Fan Zhendong knows well and plays it on the shorter side to save another game point. So alternating serves, it is deuce.
He's got another game point here, Ma Long.
10-11.
That's the most pace on a backhand we've seen Ma Long put in. It wasn't just keeping it in play. Quality shot. Really accelerates on that second one. And again, he hadn't even planted his left foot. That's where the power comes from on that shot, typically. He really put a lot of wrist and arm strength into that. And it earns him his third game point on the receive now, Ma Long.
Saves it again. Fan Zhendong.
You never know, it's a best of seven. It's only the second game, but being up 2-0 is world number one in form. Again, for me, this tells a big story. The world waits patiently, and everyone dreads the day that Ma Long will retire. But while we have him here, seeing him play live every single time feels like a gift.
Yeah, and he is looking for his first title since Tokyo 2020.
That's pretty crazy. Change of pace there. Very unusual shot from Fan Zhendong. Zhiyao Shema. I need to improve my reading. Game point for Fan Zhendong.
Well, it's Fan who takes that.
The timing off the bounce. Ma Long normally takes his pushes off the bounce so that he has so many options. Drop it short, push long, but don't give any telltale signs.
One love.
I think anytime you can either sweep up your trail or eliminate any telegraphing, suddenly your opponent has very few clues. But look at the swing of momentum for Fan Zhendong after saving three game points.
Yeah, precisely.
Love
that, when he was up against it, he really thrived in that pressure situation. And he's back on top again. Yeah, that's a look of acknowledgement. That was pretty good. Just the same, says Ma Long.
Again, those serves not leaving a lot of options. Fan Zhendong going for the long push, but Ma Long not leaving too early. Stays right in position and turns for the kill shot. Oh, speaking of which, the opposite is done here. Fan Zhendong starts to lean in over the table. And again, it's no telegraphing. Watch Ma Long serve and want the body weight there. Fan Zhendong quickly had to backpedal, and it was too late. Yeah, not exactly what he wanted there. A little shake of the head as if to say, come on, you know better. You can't do that. Off the top of the net, Ma Long saves, just redirecting traffic out here.
Nicely done.
I think to myself about the head-to-head. 16-6. Ma Long was dominant against Fan Zhendong, but five of those six wins were in their last eight encounters.
Yeah, correct.
That said, five out of eight, while it is a majority, is not crazy. It's one away from 4-4.
Ma Long's now got a 2-point lead.
4-2.
When we came up to the Olympic Games, as we see the heads of table tennis here, again, Petra Serling, president of ITTF, world veteran player, world champ, and a legend, Liu Guoliang there. We got Steve Dainton, ITTF Group president.
I think it was
CEO, rather.
Eunsung Myung, who's the vice president of the IOC, International Olympic Committee, and there with them as well.
I was going to say, though, that Fan Zhendong had been winning right before the Olympic Games, and Ma Long came back to do the unthinkable.
That was pretty unthinkable as well, wasn't it?
Absolutely mind-blowing. It is an MIB memory-erasing shot here on the move. It's another one of those where if you can even reach it, you're better than most players in the world. Leaning, and he slaps it back for a wider angle out of reach. Head down on the run and simply outdone. Fan Zhendong behind by three.
Ma Long was in a fairly similar situation to this, wasn't he, in the last game? He had that 3-4 point lead at times, and Ma Long had that lead. Fan Zhendong came back. Eight shots. You're talking about that time of dominance. It's been a while since Ma Long's won a title.
Yeah. And his dominance ends here in general with Fan Zhendong and with Wang Chuqin. Other than that, there's an occasional victor, but there are just two names that stand out. That said, you have to imagine these are the two that are going to represent China at the Olympic Games. And should everything go according to plan, we'll be playing the final.
That's surely going to be the final hurrah for Ma Long or not? The Olympics?
It's a great question. We see more retirement after the Olympics cycle than anything else. Right. At this point in time, everyone extends to play their last Olympic Games, and then suddenly there's a big farewell to a lot of our favorites.
It looks like Wang Chuqin is going to have to be a little bit more patient.
It's a long line. Tough times, tough times. This is the thing with sports and life. Five. You can be playing incredible table tennis, have a winning record against the greatest of all time and be world number three. But because world number one and two are just so strong, you just don't really get your chance. You never know. Sometimes you get a late chance in life and really shine. It's worth the wait. Ma Long had a bit of wiggle room before, but Fan Zhendong breathing down the back of the neck.
Nicely done down the line. Fan Zhendong. Just changing up the angle there. Okay, fan clubs making their presence felt. Wonder which one is a little bit ahead of the other, if that is possible. You think Ma Long, just because of his longevity, probably has more fans overall?
Yeah.
I
mean,
nobody's achieved.
The Federer of table tennis, the world sees him this way. Is Fan Zhendong the best player on the planet right now? That might well be the case, but the career is long and fruitful and untouched by anyone. I mean, he just crushes it with numbers and dominance in a way that no one else has in our lifetime and then some.
And he's got a 2-point lead here in game three. Really, a game he has to win, Adam, because do you feel at three down, it just might be, even for Ma Long, a step too far.
But you have to remember, a player who's played 10 hours already coming into this match has the ability physically to take the first three out of three games against someone who's only dropped one game. So he's going to have confidence, and there's no question he's still going to have stamina.
That lead extends to three. This is an important moment here for Ma Long.
It's an ever-changing tactical battle, a chess battle. Just looking for different angles to make the opponent crumble, to bring out the best game they can. Man with one of the most subtle and difficult serves in the game. Fast long into the serve, the open rally, backhand to backhand. Malone hasn't been stepping around nearly as much as he was earlier on. He'll step around from the middle, but he's been punished too many times for turning that backhand corner. And right now, he's set himself up with 4 game points.
Finds it up. Looking to try. Let's stop that progress of Malone.
Takes a bit of risk here, but it's a good serve right at the baseline. And as soon as he starts to turn, he had to turn early too and take the ball off the bounce to succeed in that point.
That's a couple of game points saved from Van der Donk. Still 2 more to go.
And a timeout.
The man serving.
Got it!
And he converts. Eventually gets there. Third time lucky. Tongue in cheek there. Malone does well. Serve.
Oh, some momentum here. 6 of the last 8. Yeah, that was heavy spin on that pendulum serve last time.
2 set points there for Malone in this 4th game, looking to square things up overall in the match. Three unanswered points for the ball number 2.
It's interesting. He looked quite uncomfortable, Fang Zhendong. I was looking at the backhand side of his racket. I thought I saw a little dot there. I wasn't sure if it was sweat, but his finger quickly covered it right after the serve. There it is, right before, actually. Nice hands, soft hands,
right,
deep and short.
Yeah.
This is the thing about our sport. You've got all the power in the world, but you have to know how to touch it just right to control it. And down the line again, it's that wide forehand corner of the table that's been an occasional sort of vacancy there on Malone's side.
Another one on the backhand, this time slightly different shot. More to his right-hand side.
Yeah, the forehand of Malone, the wide forehand. Years ago, right after, so 2019, he comes out of a knee surgery. I felt like Malone didn't trust his knee enough to push off and really cover that wide forehand. So he turned the corner a lot. Wow.
Talk about turning corners. Incredible from Malone.
Yeah, Fang Zhendong is basically looking into the real estate now and the schooling system on that forehand corner. Is this a good place for kids to play in the park? I've just spent so much time here, I'm really starting to like that forehand corner. Grocery stores nearby, access to freeways.
Zhendong fan club, was it?
It sounded like, and the pitch of those cheers yeah. reminded me that Fang Zhendong is the younger generation.
All square here in this 4th game. 4 all. Looking to go down the line. Riskier shot there for Malone.
Yeah, to play the forehand from that deep in the backhand corner. Has to come across the chest, which means less topspin, which also means less security. It's a little bit ironic that we call it a seatbelt shot, but it's not as safe as others.
Yeah, buckle up, guys. This is going to be quite the ride. Still a long way to go in this. Showing what he's got, Malone.
The change of placement, so quick. And again, he doesn't turn the shoulders much, so he keeps it quite well disguised. I think our umpire didn't flinch at all. That was pretty impressive. action around the net, scoops it up from off the ground. Fan Zhengdong with the feeling, and who's there to clean it up before a second bounce? You don't have to go over the net, and when you do this, Fan Zhengdong, look at that. Ma Wong has to play it so early, it was perfect to the other side.
I mean, he got it as far away from Fan as he could. Wonderfully placed.
That's incredible. We've seen master classes throughout. That would have been enough to win a point from Fan Zhengdong to come right back in and crush it with most players.
What a serve. What a serve.
Page out of the Ma Long handbook here. The fast, long serve to the forehand line. Gutsy. Wow. Right on the red line. And it had to be. He still returned it.
Yeah, did well, didn't he?
That ball would not be touched by most players in the world. A look at what it looks like inside the Infinity Arena right now. We told you beforehand, if you couldn't get your tickets today,
sorry. You were warned.
Yeah. The good news is, at capacity here, the maximum number of people are enjoying this live and in the flesh.
Getting himself up here. Fan Zhengdong. You know, nice little period in this fourth game. He's drawn level here, Fan Zhengdong. It looked like Ma Long, he had a 3-point lead earlier. It's gone.
Right before that serve, it's the second time I was reminded earlier in this match when I said there's just a level of pressure right now. Ma Long usually has so much advantage on his serve, but deep in thought, there was a look of, that's not going to be the answer. This is going to be trouble. What can I really do? Almost like at a bit of a loss for ideas, which is rare.
Well, he is just in front again here, Ma Long. So you feel that at the moment he's just a little devoid of inspiration in that sense, Ma Long?
Not inspiration so much, but in the sense that on his serve, he's aware that there's more danger on the other side. He's always quite thoughtful, very specific, and for him, he knows there's always a way. There's always a chance. He just has to find it. But the receive game on the other side has been very strong. And the fourth ball to follow. Or in this case, it could be a third and a fifth ball. But once the rally gets open, Fan Zhengdong, heavy spin there. And the backhand, the trajectory of that shot in the replay, it is so low to the net.
Play on. It all.
Reminder again, just 3 weeks ago. Ma Long won 3 straight games against Fan Zhengdong very comfortably.
That's the loudest we've heard Fan Zhengdong, and I think part
he's
of
sensing
that is,
right?
What's that?
He's sensing this is a very important juncture here, isn't it?
That, and also this is a bit of an escape because Ma Long had a shot where Fan Zhengdong was slightly off balance. Ma Long makes that shot a high percentage of the time. And if it comes down, he's not in a good position, Fan Zhengdong. So now up by one, Fan Zhengdong looking to break this into a 3-1 lead.
Yeah, there have been a number of instances in this match where shots that we've seen Ma Long put away very well, very easily, he hasn't made. And that's talking about the caliber of his opponent.
Exactly. The quality of shot that Fan Zhengdong brings to the table, there's a weight behind it. Just even staying on top of the bounce is one thing. The way it kicks so fast and accelerates, let alone controlling it.
That one there from Fan. He acknowledges that, but he moves to game point.
He's able to keep Ma Long passive there on the receive. Hasn't been easy for Ma Long. He's got the pancake flip when he needs it. Anything to surprise Fan Zhengdong, put on a little pressure from inside the table. Game point for the world number one.
This to go 3-1 up. Which he does. Fan Zhendong in a really good position now.
Love one.
It's the first time in this event this year that Ma Long has lost more than a game in the match.
And it's three.
Yeah.
And he only has one. So not ideal. Dictator would probably ask for a different situation if it could be snapped into scoreboard. Oh, I'm a little surprised actually that ended the rally as quickly as it did. Save for Ma Long, a little bit short. This camera angle will be interesting. You could see the sweat flying from the start here. Chop block sort of lob. Hits the hand of Ma Long. That's part of the reason for the little frustrated look there.
Yeah, white shanked to the right.
2-1.
So from Ma Long's perspective now, Adam, what we've seen a lot of what Fun's been doing. What should Ma Long be doing?
Well, I think this is a good answer as well. Tight serves, quick attacks to the middle, hit the corners where he can, occasionally mix it up. But again, turning the corner, he's going to have to be very selective about when he decides to step around the corner on the backhand side. You might even see him pull out some different serves or different placement from the start of the serve. So right here, he comes out with a long serve.
Yeah, I was just about to say, that was a long serve.
Right, an unusual serve. Fast and long to the backhand. Well played. But a very well prepared and not overly anxious Fan Zhendong stays patiently right there so he can get the backhand into play. Had he moved in early, as many players would like to, he'd be punished.
Yeah, nice back in the middle of it all, Ma Long, but it's Fan who wins a point.
Right, the chop block comes out early on for Ma Long and then quickly right back on track. That's the chop block. A little higher than usual. Good read from Fan Zhendong. Just goes to show you how incredible Truls Morgaard's chop blocks are. So varied.
Yeah.
I mean, he won a high percentage of points when he was playing that shot, and he made so many.
The Fun's looking good here. He wins this game. He takes the final.
Remember, Ma Long, no timeouts left. He cashed it in to take game number three. Yes, when he does step around, he has to make it count. And this is as wide as can be, meaning if it comes back, it's very unlikely to come back to the short side of the table. And also, he timed it when Fan Zhendong was inside the table and had to backpedal to cover that corner.
So, better here from Ma Long. He's drawn level. And apply the pressure back on Fan Zhendong.
Nice change of rhythm, really. Ma Long mixing it up with these spinny backhands. Sometimes more of a forward motion, a faster driving shot. Other times a little bit more arc on it. Something to keep Fan Zhendong out of rhythm, a little bit hesitant, slightly more passive.
Again, beautifully done, Ma Long.
This is the shot that Ma Long does against everybody in the world, and Fan Zhendong has shut down. But a little bit of topspin on it. From that camera angle, you could see it's a little loose, way inside the table from that camera angle. But Ma Long saw that there was the height on it. He's able to come through and over the ball in a way that lifts it, even with the table in the way as an obstacle.
Louder, isn't he, Fan Zhendong?
People getting shushed in the crowd.
Went for the long serve again. Marlon.
6-5.
Just a reminder, each player has one timeout per match. Marlon has already used his. Van Jeongdong still has his in the bag. I think at this point in this game, there'd have to be a pretty different scoreline. If Malone continues the way he's going, I think it would be saved for later.
6-6.
Tense moments here. Van Jeongdong, 5 points more required to win this final.
Yeah, we feel you. Nerve-wracking in the crowd.
Absolutely right.
Whoa. Thought I saw my friend Richard there. Perth, Australia.
Oh, those are the ones you're talking about that flow in?
No. Oh. They're Australians.
Trading points at the moment, these two.
Been a while since we've seen Ma Long looking so comfortable to block and re-guide those backhands from just behind the table. It all started with the touch shot from Van Jeongdong, and Ma Long had to play from baseline defensively.
Left. 6-7.
Got the crowd nervous here.
From Van Jeongdong.
Yeah, they both speak English. I think it's just that, in general, nobody wants to look stupid and feels like if you speak and you say the wrong thing, it takes a certain level of confidence to publicly give a speech the way Ma Long did.
Yeah, Ma Long is, he does do it in his, some of the post-match interviews as well, doesn't he? We've seen it from him. The crowd love it when he does that.
He really wants to promote the sport and knows that speaking English is going to help a lot.
Number of long serves from him in this game, Marlon.
Right, the percentage that we saw, 50% to that deep backhand corner. I think he's so well practiced. If you look at aces in table tennis, if you search on YouTube, you're going to find a lot of Marlon. You're going to find a lot of Waldner too. Takes a level of confidence, creativity, and what are you thinking?
Well, as you've said before, it's usually the conversations about the greatest revolve around those two as well. Correlation
Absolutely.
There.
That's right.
You want to serve me, Elon? Here's my response.
It's almost like a second shot ace. Right back down the line. Man, punished. Was it long enough? The truth is, Van Jeongdong is picking up on this pattern. Yeah. He's waiting patiently.
Right.
I think that means Ma Long's going to have to find other ways to surprise. Sometimes doing the more ordinary, traditional thing can be surprising if the opponent's expecting anything else.
Marlon in a bit of trouble now, perhaps. Van Jeongdong needs just two more points.
It's funny, I think there's nobody in the world who doesn't like Van Jeongdong. And the same for Marlon. They're both absolutely adored in the table tennis world. No one wishes them any ill will or misfortune. That said, so many people still want to see Marlon continue because it inspires belief that anything is possible at 34.
And that could still continue.
There is an element of superheroism here. I mean, just the level that he brings to the game still over so many years. And we saw it in China. It was the trials for the world championships that'll be coming up in South Africa in Durban. Ma Long taking the first spot there with authority, but it's 9-9, only 2 points between them. Ma Long hasn't had too many answers on serve. He's had his stress. He's got two serves right here that could determine the outcome of this match.
Let's see what he picks here. He's gone with the long serve quite a bit in this game and the previous one.
Let 9-0.
Now, does he go with the same thing? In a way, that's telegraphed now, isn't it? What will he do? Championship point here.
The forehand to forehand battle. This is Ma Long's weapon. And the spin that he tries to put on, it takes all the footwork to get back into position, but it's forehand to backhand for half of that rally. And as soon as Fan Zhendong goes into the body, look at the placement on that last shot. Right there, it forces Ma Long to play it from about hip height. Perfect move as Fan Zhendong changes it up 1 point away from defending his title over the captain, the dragon, the dictator.
Fan Zhendong has won the Singapore Smash once again.